Hello dear students, we are going to learn a topic today, division, gymnosperm. It is a part 5 of chapter plant kingdom, division, gymnosperm. Students, in cryptogams, 3 division we have already learned. First, thallophyte, bryophyte and pteridophyte. Cryptogams is differ from the phanerogams. The division gymnosperm belong to phanerogams. Phanerogams is a flowering plants, so not flowering, it is a seed containing plants. Gymnos, naked seed as well as closed seed bearing plants belong to the phanerogams, in which gymnosperm is one of them. Gymnosperm is made up of 2 Greek word. First is gymnos, it means naked. Naked, and sperma, it means seeded. In general, the gymnosperm is also called naked seeded plant. Means seed is not enclosed inside the fruit. The plants belong in the gymnosperm are naked seeded. Students, this is the smallest group in which very less number of plants are exist, about 73 genera till date is reported, and from this 73 genera, about 7000 species reported from this group. This plant is the term gymnosperm was given by Theophrastus. Theophrastus used the term gymnosperm, and Goebel is a name of scientist who proposed phanerogams without ovary. Phanerogams without ovary. This is a definition for gymnosperm. Means if ovary present inside the gymnosperm, it must form fruit. But fruit formation is totally absent in case of gymnosperm. So this plant group is also called gymnosperm or naked seeded plant group. Now, what will be the distribution of the gymnosperm? Especially gymnosperm found in all part of the world, in all topic of all type of climatic condition, but they are mostly grow in temperate region. Distribution basically in temperate region, yani those zone who found in cold climatic condition. Found with cold climatic conditions means zone having cold conditions, especially this plant are grown, especially gymnosperm are grown. Examples like pinus, especially pinus forest is reported from in India, from especially in Himachal Pradesh and some part of Jammu Kashmir. This is the pinus plants. Beside this, the cycas is also grow in this, and in this zone, in our zone also, basically as ornament plants. Cycas have many species, but most of the cycas is most dominance group of cycas plant found inside the India. India is a famous for cycas plant. This one is a distribution basically in temperate region. Some species is also found in the desert also. In desert locations also found species is Welwitschia, Witschia. This is a name of plant, Welwitschia, that are desert, especially grow in desert area, especially you can say in Sahara desert they are prominently grown. On this basis, we can say this plant, especially the gymnosperm plant, mostly temperate, but some can be grow in the tropical condition, subtropical condition, especially in desert also. And in India, This is a total genera that are present in all over the world. 73 genera and 7,000 species, out of which about 16 genera are reported from India. 16 genera reported from India. India have majority number of species of gymnosperm, especially 16 species. This is the more in number as in all 73 gymnosperm members. Now, students, what is the salient feature? What characteristics the gymnosperm have? Which type of character found? You know that, student, the gymnosperm is the naked seeded plants, means that doesn't have any type of ovary. So what is a characteristic feature? Characteristic feature of gymnosperm. First, what is a characteristic feature of gymnosperm? Gymnosperm have well-defined root, stem, leaf and reproductive parts, especially reproductive parts present inside the plants. All root, stem, leaf and reproductive part present in the plants. Root basically found in the form of tap root system, especially beside the tap root system, some additional root is also found, is called coralloid root. This is a additional root that are arise from the base of the plant, especially the cycas plants, which emerge out from the base of the plants and form a dichotomy like structures, slightly bented dichotomy like structures near the base of the plants. And this coralloid root is known for the symbiotic association with blue green algae. Symbiotic association with blue green algae. Especially the coralloid root found in case of cycas. Cycas coralloid root you have ever seen in many other side and reference book, what is a coralloid root. I think in NCERT is not described what is a coralloid root, how they are found. This cycas plant have coralloid root and having symbiotic association with blue green algae. In short, it is also called blue green algae or cyanobacteria. Especially the member of Anabina nostoc present inside the root and they form association with them. Beside this, how they perform symbiosis, because my cyanobacteria help in the fixing nitrogen provide to the plant and in revenge the plant provides shelter to the cyanobacteria. Beside this, some other plant special root are also form mycorrhizal association in case of pinus. In case of mycorrhizal association, this is description about the root, which type of root present inside the gymnosperm. Example, the mycorrhizal association found in case of pinus plant. Pinus is a plant which have association. How the mycorrhizal association form? Mycorrhizal association form root with fungi, root of higher plant. You can say the gymnosperm is also higher group of plants, root of higher plants plus fungal member, they form association. This is called mycorrhizal association reported in case of pinus. These two type of association basically found inside the gymnosperm with root. So tap root system is basically present inside the we must learn which type of wood found. Wood are two types of inside the gymnosperm. First is a monoxylic wood. and second is a pycnoxylic wood. Pycnoxylic wood. It means that the monoxylic wood are those in which tissues arrangement as present in the form of fibrous. They are in fibrous form. Monoxylic. Especially the cycas plant. You have seen the cycas plant in the different parks, like in your cities, like in Bihi Park. If you visit from the way, both side of the is decorated by the cycas plant. This is a cycas and leaf like. Now I want to prepare. What is a structure of cycas? Here cone like structure is also present in them, and I am not preparing as like such like plants, but it look like that in all leaf. Suppose this is a all leaf that arise from the tip positions especially, and they are long. You can say this is a foliage leaf present inside this foliage leaf. Students, one question is also, one more characteristic also is this plant is evergreen, means leaf are not deciduous type, means if the leaf are form, they are persist through the year, means they are green and persist through the year, means it is evergreen plants, is always be green and look like green plants. Student, this is a plant having leaf, many leaf that arise from the tip position of the tree. This is a form of crown shaped structures, and this is a cone. Suppose this is a reproductive part, is called cone also form in case of male plants, but in cycas it is not forming. Cone is not forming female plants. This is a cycas and this type of structure, and this is a structure scars of leaf. Because in annual one time leaf are form and they are fall down, again another leaf is arise from the same plant. This type of I think you may understand what is a structure of cycas. This is a cycas. Students, cycas is a evergreen. Wood is two type, monoxylic and pycnoxylic. The cycas plant especially have monoxylic wood. Cycas plant especially have monoxylic wood, means the root present inside the wood present inside the stem is a monoxylic fibrous, and they are not used for making any type of furniture in this. You can say simply understand and not going to form any furniture from this type of wood. But pycnoxylic wood is hard and woody. It is a woody, and it is possible to form. It is possible to form any type of furnitures, especially the ply and so many other things. Especially the pycnoxylic wood, especially present in case of a plant is called pinus. Pinus is a plant which having pycnoxylic wood. This is a difference between monoxylic and pycnoxylic wood, where monoxylic wood is found and where is a pycnoxylic wood is found. Students, in Gorakhpur district, I think till date now I have seen 2-3 plants of pinus. 2-3 plants of pinus. One of in just near the passport office of the Gorakhpur, and another is in railway colony of near Mohadipur. But beside this, many research center must having pinus in their garden, and pinus in their garden. The leaf of this plant is very interesting. They are just like a thread, and they are moving downward. This type of pinus needle is especially the leaf of pinus is called pinus needle, that are present inside the pinus plant. But the leaf of cycas you can see. Students, due to formation of this type of wood, they must show secondary growth. I am not going to write what is secondary growth, but the pinus and cycas plant must show secondary growth. Plant is evergreen, especially grow in temperate region. Now, third point, which type of vascular tissues are found? You know that, students, the vascular tissues present inside the plant is basically two type. First is a xylem and second is a phloem. In primary classes, not primary, in previous classes, in class 9th and even in 10th, transport of water and mineral in plants, you have already discussed about xylem and phloem. In 9th also, about the diversity of living organism in chapter, the plants and animal plants, tissues, xylem and phloem are also described. The xylem form two type of cells, xylem fiber, xylem tracheid, xylem vessels, and xylem parenchyma. This all type of tissue present, all in all four, this tissue all are present inside the gymnosperm, but xylem vessel is absent in case of gymnosperm. Xylem vessels is absent. Xylem vessels is absent in case of gymnosperm. In case of phloem also, phloem form four type of tissue, phloem fiber, phloem parenchyma, sieve tube and companion cell. Students, in all phloem, all this phloem fiber, phloem parenchyma and phloem, sieve tubes are present inside the phloem in gymnosperm, but companion cell is absent in case of gymnosperm. Means the xylem without vessels in gymnosperm are found and phloem without companion cell found inside the phloem. This is a basic difference between vascular tissues of gymnosperm and angiosperm. In angiosperm, all type of tissue, xylem fiber, xylem parenchyma, xylem tracheids and xylem vessels, all type of tissue found in angiosperm. Angiosperm is a more advanced group of plants that are all are found. In same case, phloem are also have all type of tissues in gymnosperms, angiosperm, but not in gymnosperm. Companion cell is absent in gymnosperms. Beside this, another interesting point, an order present inside the gymnosperm is called needles. Order present inside the gymnosperm is called needles. Needles is the second class, especially coniferophyta, members of coniferophyta. This is order of coniferophyta, needles, and needles having characters that match with the gymnosperm as well as angiosperms. Means it is a link between two, gymnosperm and angiosperm. Another type of topic is also told by any teachers to you, that the gymnosperm is also link between pteridophyte and angiosperm. This just a mediator which explore that the pteridophytes directly originate into the angiosperm by the gymnosperms. You can say the pteridophyte more advanced into the gymnosperm and then into the angiosperms. The origin points of gymnosperm at the late Paleozoic era, this is a duration. They are formed in late Paleozoic era, but this was most dominant group during the Mesozoic era. I think you are unable to understand how this is, this can be understood, Paleozoic, Mesozoic and Cenozoic era. This topic, I think different epoch, era and what is the time duration in which different plants and animal species are evolved, this will understand in class 12 chapter 7, evolution, especially evolution of flowering plants. I'm not going to discuss detail about eras, but you may learn must it the Mesozoic era in which the gymnosperm form. Now, Fourth point is now I'm going to talk about the reproductive parts. Reproductive parts. Especially the male and female plants able to form their reproductive part. But the male plants able to form their cone. In case of cycadels, this one is comparison, cycadel, cycas. Female form, not form cone, means cone absent. Here one structure I am going to show you. This is a male cone of, this is a male cone of cycas. This is a cycas male cone. The cycas is having monozygote, so it is not a woody, but the pinus cone is a woody. This is a difference. This is a male cone, so it is a form a structure. This is a sporophyll. This is a sporophyll, and sporophyll bear numerous spore, sori at the ventral side, and each sori having sporangia, and that bear spore. Cone bear microsporophyll. Microsporophyll bear microsporangia. You can say first sori, then microsporangia. Microsporangia bear microspore. This is a male cone. But female, in case of female, cone are not formed. Directly they form megasporophyll. Students, one more point to be remember, it is must for you, because the micro, when micro word is used in gymnosperm or in pteridophyte or in bryophyte, it means that it is talking about male parts, and mega it is a female parts. Why mega micro word is used? You know that the gametes of male is especially small, and gametes of female is large. So for this type, for this point of view, the male and female word is used in case of micro and mega in both cases. The megasporophyll having megasporangium, and megasporangium bear megaspore. Megasporangium bear megaspore. In cycas, this is a male. This is a sexual reproductive part. Sexual reproductive part, but asexual reproductive part also have, it is called bulbil. This is a cycas plant. Bulbil is arise from the, from this position. This is a bulbil. This is a leaf from bulbil. There have been a reserve material in it, and if the bulbil detach from the stem, especially the cycas plant is unbranched, it is not branched. This bulb is not considered, it is not a type of branch, it is a part that arises from the some stem and base and tip, another part, and they detach from the stem and grow on another site, they form a new plants. This is a bulbil. This is a reproduced by the asexual or vegetative method of propagation. Especially in asexual, this is a method of vegetative propagation. This is a bulbil. Now the male bear microsporangium, and microsporangium bear microspore. Female have megasporangium, megaspore. They again fertilize to form zygote. This type of structure they form zygote, and zygote again develop to form a sporophyte. Especially in gymnosperm, the life is a diplontic. Diplontic means a sporophytic life is dominant as compared to the gametophyte. A sporophyte life is dominant, and gametophyte depend on it. Especially in gymnosperm, in pteridophyte also, and in angiosperm also. Now, this how the micro megasporangium is formed, you can understand this by the life cycle of the gymnosperm. Here the two fertilization event is observed, and nucellus zygote formed by the gametic fusion of male and female, male and female gametic fusion, and it bear endosperm. But endosperm of gymnosperm not as like angiosperm. Gymnosperm endosperm is haploid in nature. This is a question, objective question of competitive examination. Which type of endosperm is found? It is a haploid nature of endosperm found inside the gymnosperm. Students, endosperm in case of cycas, the single endosperm are found, but in case of pinus, the number should increase, not number of endosperm up to reaches 9 endosperm found in case of pinus case. It is a 9 type of nine endosperm inside the single ovules they have. So you can say this is a basic difference between the endosperm of the male gamete reaches to the female gamete through the air. This type of pollination is called anemophilous pollination observed in case of anemophilous pollination occur in case of gymnosperm. Anemophilous means the pollination through the wind. This is type of pollination is called anemophilous. Here one basic point, due to absence of ovary, no fruit formation observed in case of gymnosperm. Now this is the salient feature of gymnosperm. How, what is the character of gymnosperm, what is the reproductive part, in all aspect I am talking here, different form, different characteristics. Now after this I am going to talk about classification of gymnosperm. Gymnosperm is a division. It is classified into subdivision. First subdivision is called Psychdophyta, and this is called Coniferophyta. This is a type of subdivision. In NCERT, it may be Psychedels, coniferals also generally used directly, the order sometime used in this case. One more interesting things, the gymnosperm is a part of phanerogamia, but some book also it is also called tracheata. You can say it is called spermophyta means seed bearing plants. Sometime the gymnosperm is also placed by some scientist into the spermatophyta, and spermatophyta divide into forms is just, first is a gymnosperm, second is angiosperm, and gymnosperms it is a part of spermatophyta, further divide into the two subdivisions, psychedophyta and coniferophyta. Psychedophyta also further classified into the three order. First is a psyche, I think it was psychedophilicals. Second is a benetitals, and third is a psychedels. This is a different order of the psychedophyta. This is a subdivision, psychedophyta further divided into the three order. I think a student in class 11 chapter 1, the hierarchy condition you already learned. What is a taxonomical hierarchy? The smallest hierarchy is a species and largest hierarchy is kingdom. And they are arranged by kingdom, division, subdivision, phylum, family, order, class, not family, class, order, genus, species. This type of sequence of arrangement. In many cases, this all sequence of arrangement is not follow. Especially phylum is used not for plant. Some division in many cases not going to use class, and family is not going to use in gymnosperm. This may be used in angiosperm. Especially if the members, if the higher number of members present in the single group, they form a complex taxonomical hierarchy. But if the very less number, like gymnosperm having 73 genera only, it is not to classify the more complex system of classifications. It is very easy because the number of species is very less or very less. Now second is coniferophyta, further classified into the four order. First is carditales. Second is nettles, gingoels, carditales, coniferals and nettles. This is the four order. Students, cycadae word is used. One of the famous genera of cycas. Second is Gygnema. This is the member of cycas. Gygnema is the member of cycadales. Not Gygnema, it is a Jamia. This is the very famous genera, Jamia. Is also called Jamia pygmaea. Full name is Jamia pygmaea. And nettles is one member is called Gingko. It having bilobed leaf, like this type of leaf present inside the Gingko. This is the Gingko species found in area of Himachal Pradesh. Coniferals is called famous species is a pinus, and here famous species is called neetum. Neetum having basals, one member. Nettles is having similarities with the angiosperm and more similarities with the gymnosperm. It is a link between gymno and angiosperm because it is a last order of the coniferophyta. It indicates that it having similarities with the angiosperm because basal is totally present inside the nettles. You must remember this point. Now cycas and Jamia pygmaea. Students, the smallest species of the gymnosperm is Jamia, having size of 25 centimeter. Smallest species of the gymnosperm is Jamia, having size of 25 centimeter. But some species of gymnosperm having tallest height about 366 feet. It is called Sequoia sempervirens. It is a full name is Sequoia sempervirens, having height up to the 366 feet, means ranging from 25 centimeter up to the 366 feet. You can imagine about 100 meter tall plants are belong to the gymnosperm. It is a very interesting subdivision of the plant kingdoms. The cycas plant having average height of the 5 meter, up to 5 meter the plant have, not more than this, only up to 3 to 4 meter total length of this plant, up to 3 to 4 meter also observed in this case. This is the different members. Here one example is called cardites. Cardites in gingoels, Gingko, coniferals is a pinus, nettles is a neetum. Here cycadales is called cycas and Jamia, and Benetitales is a Williamsonia. Is called Williamsonia. It is reported also from India, from Rajmahal Hills. Williamsonia, this is a name of a species. One important, this cycadophilicals and Benetitales is an extinct group. Majority members, about almost all member of this cycadophilicals is extinct. Till date are not present on earth, and some members are living here, but majority are also extinct in this group. means this is a totally extinct group and extinct order of the cycadels. This is the cycadophilicals. The species is in cycadophilicals is Medullosa. Examples, Medullosa. This is a different order. What is the basic difference? Cycadophilus, this is a foliage type of leaf in Cycadophyta. Wood is a monoxylic. Here needle type of leaf and for some time foliobes and lobed leaf present inside the Cycadophyta, and wood is a pycnoxylic. Wood are found in case of coniferals. If any members that relate with gymnosperm, first identify which type of wood present in the plant, especially the wood having monoxylic present in the Cycadophyta and wood having pycnoxylic means woody stem, sorry, plants having pycnoxylic wood and must be placed into the coniferophyta. This is the basic difference between it. Now students, after this, what is the what is the basic difference, what is the economic importance of the, why the study of gymnosperm is must, what is important to perform a study, and what we get from gymnosperm, you know that the students, it is basically the most member of this species are ornamental. What it is a, you can say second is a economic importance, how the plant can be use for mankind. First, it is a, most of the species is ornamental. Ornamentals, it can be decorate the garden, home, especially the member of Cycas is called Cycas revoluta, Cycas rumphii. This is the species that of Cycas, it is basically used as ornamentals. Second is it is also used for edible purposes, especially sago, especially you can say the sabudana word is used, is the rich of starch, especially extract from the Cycas revoluta species, especially Cycas revoluta. Cycas revoluta species, especially sago is extracted from this. This is a rich in starch content. Now the pitha plant is used as edible. Pitha of some plant used as a food, as a edibles. Used as a food, yeah, you can say as a edibles. They are used as a consumption purposes. They also have a medicinal value. Some plants of the Cycas as well as Pinus having medicinal value, especially root and leaf of the plant is used as a medicines, especially the Cycas sarsinellus leaf is used in the medicines, and some other plants like in case of Pinus, its species is neetum. Neetum is used as a medicinal purposes, especially in the rheumatic pain. Beside this, some another features and in case of wood, especially a pinus wood is used in the making of furniture, especially because they are having pycnoxylic wood and used for making furniture. Students, in this chapter, I think this is overall part of gymnosperms. If you want to study more, then you can take help of reference book, and I think in reference book it is given details. Thank you.